Hello and welcome to the Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on limiting reagents. Often in a reaction, there is not enough of one reactant to react completely with the other. So the limiting reagent is the reactant that runs out first and limits the amount of product that can be produced. The excess reagent is the reactant that is not completely used up in a reaction and which there's excess of. Let's look at a non-chemistry example first. You have 8 graham crackers, 6 marshmallows, and 10 pieces of chocolate. How many s'mores can you make if each one has 2 graham crackers, 1 marshmallow, and 1 piece of chocolate? What do you have left over? So you'll see that we can make 4 s'mores, and we have 6 pieces of chocolate left over and 2 marshmallows left over. That makes the graham crackers the limiting reagent, or the reactant that we ran out of first and which limits the amount of s'mores that can be made. The chocolate and the marshmallows are both excess reagents because we have extra of each of those. Now let's look at a more chemistry-specific example. How much zinc chloride can be produced from the reaction of 2 moles of zinc and 3 moles of hydrochloric acid? Which is the limiting reagent? For your first step, you're going to check for a correctly balanced equation. And in this example, our reaction is already balanced. The second step is to determine the limiting reagent. And we can do this one of two ways. The first way is to determine how much product can be made from each of the given reagents. First, let's start with our 2 moles of zinc. In order to convert moles of zinc to moles of zinc chloride, we need to use the coefficients in our correctly balanced chemical equation. This tells us that 1 mole of zinc is required for every 1 mole of zinc chloride that is produced. Now remember, you can only convert from moles of one reactant or product to moles of another reactant or product. So if you were given amounts in grams, your first step will be to convert those amounts in grams to moles, and then you can use the coefficients in your balanced chemical equation. This tells us that 2 moles of zinc and excess hydrochloric acid can make 2 moles of zinc chloride. Now let's look at how much zinc chloride can be made from the 3 moles of hydrochloric acid that we start with. Again, we'll use the coefficients in our balanced chemical equation, which tell us that for every 1 mole of zinc chloride produced, we need 2 moles of hydrochloric acid. This tells us that with 3 moles of hydrochloric acid and excess zinc, 1.5 moles of zinc chloride could be produced. Now, what you'll notice from these calculations is that 3 moles of hydrochloric acid can at most produce 1.5 moles of zinc chloride. So it doesn't matter that we have extra zinc. And so even though our 2 moles of zinc could theoretically make 2 moles of zinc chloride, in this reaction, the hydrochloric acid will run out first after the production of 1.5 moles of zinc chloride, and this is our theoretical yield. This makes HCl the limiting reagent. And so in this equation, the 3 moles of HCl would react with zinc in order to form 1.5 moles of zinc chloride, and this would mean that you would have excess zinc left over because there was no more hydrochloric acid left for the zinc to react with. And even though this problem doesn't ask for our excess reagent, this means that zinc is the excess reagent. Another method that you can use to determine the limiting reagent is to determine how much of one reactant the other reactant requires to react completely. Then you can use the limiting reagent to determine the maximum amount of product that can be made. So in method one, we determined how much product could be made individually from each of the reactants if we assume that they react with excess of the other reagent. And then from the amount of product that can be produced, we could determine our limiting reagent. In this method, we'll determine our limiting reagent first and then use the limiting reagent to calculate the theoretical yield. You can use whichever method makes more sense to you, and in either case, you end up doing two calculations. You can start with either the 2 moles of zinc or the 3 moles of hydrochloric acid, but I'm choosing to start with 2 moles of zinc. I then use my balanced chemical equation to calculate how much HCl would be required to react with 2 moles of zinc. This tells me that in order to react 2 moles of zinc completely, 4 moles of hydrochloric acid are required. But in our problem, we are only given 3 moles of hydrochloric acid, which means that hydrochloric acid must be the limiting reagent. We can now use the limiting reagent to calculate the amount of product that can be theoretically produced. So now we start with the limiting reagent, 3 moles of HCl. We then use the coefficients in our balanced chemical equation to convert from moles of HCl to moles of zinc chloride. And we arrive at the same answer. Using our limiting reagent, the theoretical yield of zinc chloride that can be produced is 1.5 moles of zinc chloride. And so the same answer is obtained regardless of the method used. Thanks for watching The Chemistry Solution. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial.